measuring sister with me. We are going to demonstrate how an angioplasty is being done.
The procedure is same like an angiogram. First we have to give local anesthesia here. This is the subcutaneous tissue above the radial artery. The radial artery is the access to the coronary artery. Okay, this is the puncture needle. We have to pass this needle into the radial artery. So that's what I am doing now. Okay, now the needle is inside the radial artery and I will remove the needle, and now you can see the blood is gushing out of the radial artery. So now what I do is I pass this wire. Now the wire is inside the radial artery, and over this wire I will be passing a radial artery sheath. This sheath is bigger than the sheath which we use for an angiogram. This is to allow the bigger guiding catheters, balloons and wires etc. to pass through. Now I am passing the sheath into the radial artery, and then what I do is I will remove away this wire and dilator. Okay. What I am doing is I am going to give the cocktail which contains diltiazem, nitroglycerin and heparin. Diltiazem and nitroglycerin is used to dilate the artery to make it larger, and then we give heparin. Heparin is to prevent blood clotting during the angioplasty. So usually we give 1000 units per kilogram of heparin. It's 100 units per kilogram of heparin. This is the extra backup guiding catheter. This is the 6 French guiding catheter. It is through this guiding catheter we pass the wires, balloons, stents, etc. Now I am advancing it. It will be advanced over a wire. There will be a wire here. So I am inserting it into the sheath. And now through the X-ray, under X-ray guidance, we will be passing everything into the heart.
Light up.
Pause panel. Zoom panel. Okay, now the wire is being advanced through the arteries of the hand, and that artery ends in the aorta. Now I am advancing the artery, the wire into the aorta, and the guiding catheter is also advance over the wire into the aorta. Then I remove the wire away and I am connecting the Y connector. This is called a Y connector, and this is connected to the manifold. Through this manifold we can measure the blood pressure of the patient, and also it is also connected to the dye or contrast to visualize the arteries. Okay, that is the, on the monitor you can see the patient's blood pressure. The blood pressure is fine. The blood pressure is continuously monitored during the procedure. Okay. Now I am pushing the guiding catheter to engage the coronary artery. Okay, now I have maneuvered the guiding catheter to engage the coronary artery. Give a check system. Okay, that is the coronary artery. That is the left system. The main, left main dividing into circumflex and LAD. Okay, AP caudal. Now I am performing an angiogram to identify the block. Angiogram is done in different views. Okay, brother, freeze point. Okay, this is the aerocranial view. You can see that the patient has a tight 99% block. You can see that there is a separation between the two black parts. So that is a block. He's got a 99% block, and that is why blood is not flowing in that particular area. It is very narrow. You can see the red light on the block. So this is another view. You can see that there is a 99% block there. That gap, that or the portion where dye is not flowing, that is a area of the block. So now what I am going to do is I will pass a wire into the through the block. Then I will put a balloon and dilate it, and then place a stent. Okay. This is the coronary wire which we are going to pass into the artery of the heart or the coronary artery. Okay. So what I'll do is this is the introducer needle. I'll put it into this guiding catheter hub, and then I will be advancing the wire like this. Okay. Then what I'll do is I'll just remove this introducer. Now the wire has come into the guiding catheter. Now I will be slowly pushing it into the coronary artery. Okay. Now what I'm doing is I'm advancing the wire into the coronary artery. Wire is near the block. Now what I'll do is, I'll advance this wire. Okay, now I have crossed the block. Now you can see that I am advancing the wire into the coronary artery. I take it, lower down, show down. Okay, so now I have crossed the block. Now all the ballooning, stenting, etc. will be done over the wire. Okay. This is the balloon with which we are going to dilate the blood vessel. The balloon is here at the tip, and this is connected to a ring deflator, which when we rotate, the pressure will go up and the balloon will open. So now this balloon is going to be threaded on a wire, on this wire. Okay. The wire is being threaded by Vigneshwari sister. Okay. And she will fix the wire while I advance the balloon into the catheter. Like this. Then we will watch it on the screen. So that is the balloon where you can see two black markers. The balloon is in between the two markers. So now I am pushing it into the coronary artery over the wire. And sister, front check. Wait, 1 minute. Pause. Okay, now the balloon is positioned across the block. And now we will inflate the balloon and open it. Okay. So now I am inflating the balloon. This is the, you can see the pressure here on this dial, and you can watch that the block is being opened. Yeah, it is a tight block, but it has opened nicely. Okay, that is a balloon. It is inflated, and now the block is opened. Okay. Check the contrast and see the result of the dilatation. Yes, it has opened nicely. Now what we will be doing is we will remove the balloon. Out of the guiding catheter, and then we will do some measurements to decide about the stent diameter, length, etc. So I am removing the balloon now from the guiding catheter. The balloon has come out of the guiding catheter. Now I just remove it like this, and then I will wipe the wire. Okay, this is the stent. I have done some measurements. What stent I have taken is 2.75 millimeter diameter and 23 millimeters length. You can see this metal alloy is actually, it's an alloy, is the stent, and there is a drug coated on it, so it's a drug coated stent. And she will thread it and give it to me. The stent is connected to an ring deflator again, just like the balloon. Okay. So now I am opening the hub and advancing the stent through the guiding catheter. Now, guiding catheter, now it has entered the coronary artery. You can see that there are two markers. The stent is being advanced and it will be positioned across the site of the block. Stent has been positioned. I am going to check whether the position is correct by injecting dye. The position of the stent looks fine. Now, sister will be deploying the stent. Go up. She is going up. Nominal is 8. Go to 6. Okay, now you can watch the stent also being deployed there. Okay, now what I am doing is I am deflating the balloon. So now the stent is deployed. Now I am going to see the result of the stenting. Yeah, the stent looks fine. It looks well deployed. The stent was mounted on the balloon. Now I am just removing the balloon away. And I will be removing it from this guiding catheter. That is the balloon on which the stent was mounted. Now only the balloon is there, the stent has been deployed. Now I just remove the balloon. Yeah. Okay, now the stenting has been done. Now the thing is, we have to, there are certain areas of the stent which are under deployed. So we have to use a bigger balloon and inflate it and make the stent well opposed onto the coronary artery. So this is the balloon, bigger balloon, which I am going to use to make the stent bigger. Okay, sister is now threading the balloon on the wire. Now she will fix the wire while I advance the balloon. Has reached the guiding catheter tip. Now I am advancing the balloon into the stent to make the stent bigger. Okay. Now I am using a technology called stent boost, which will clearly show the balloon inside the stent, because we should not inflate the balloon outside the stent. See, now we can clearly see that the balloon is inside the stent and not outside the stent. So now what I will do is, I will make the stent bigger by inflating it. The balloon, you can see on the fluoro that I am inflating it. I go to high pressures by watching the stent and balloon. Then I deflate it. Then what I do is, I will pull back the balloon more into the stent and dilate the entire stent. Now I am again dilating the stent. There are certain portions which were under deployed. Then wait for some time and then deflate it. Now I again pull back the balloon further to again dilate that portion of the stent. Boost. Now I am inflating it further. 14 is how much?
14, sir.
3.2. Now I am doing the dilatation of the edge of the stent. And now I deflate the balloon. So now the stent has been completely dilated. Okay, after the dilatation, I am doing a check shot and seeing, yeah, the result looks good. There is no damage or perforation or dissection of the vessel, and the result looks fine. Now what I'll do is I'll just remove the balloon away. I'm checking it in another angle just to see whether there is any perforation or any complications. Everything looks fine in that view also. Okay, now since the procedure is over, I'm removing the wire and balloon out of the guiding catheter. Now I will do the last and final check shots to assess for any complications and how the result is. Okay, all views are there. Epigrail, RI grail. Go to RI grail first. That's not time. RI grail. Okay, I'm doing all the check shots. Yeah, the result looks very good. Yeah. Okay, looks fine in that also. Nice. Okay, so that's the final shot. Everything looks good. Okay, the angioplasty is over, and now I am removing the guiding catheter from the coronary artery. And then what I will do is I will remove this manifold here, and the sister will pass me the wire, and I will advance the wire into the guiding catheter, and I will watch on fluoro. The wire has exited out of the guiding catheter, and then I will remove it. I will remove it as a single unit from the coronary artery and also the radial artery. And that is it. The angioplasty is over. It is a successful case. Now this sheath will be removed later, maybe after 2-3 hours. Once we check the clotting time, it is called ACT. Once it is less than 150, we will remove the sheath, and then the procedure is done, and mostly the patient will be discharged in another 24 hours. Before 5 o'clock tomorrow he will be discharged. We will just observe him in the ICU for a day to see whether there are any complications, which can be 1-2%. That is why they need continuous monitoring. So this is how angioplasties are done in our center. And this, even though the angioplasty looks very simple, this was, and blocks are of different types, type A, B1, B2C. This is a type A lesion, which is one of the simplest angioplasties. That is why it looks rather straightforward. But we do a lot of complex angioplasties like graft interventions, rod ablation of calcified vessels, and bifurcation angioplasties, left main angioplasties, 100% occlusions. There are a wide plethora of complex lesions which we handle in our center. So this is Sister Vipneshri who assisted me. So this is my team who helps me with all the complex angioplasties. Vipneshri sister, our technician brother Satish, brother Alex, sister Jyoti, and sister Sindhu. And always the person who does the filming is our sister Yamini sister, who is a professional videographer right now. So signing off from beyond.